Good morning to you all. Today I am going to start unit 4 in the subject engineering graphics. In unit 4, two concepts are covered. First concept, development of surfaces. Sheet metal work related fabricated parts based upon this concept, that is development of surfaces. What is a development? Let's see the definition. Development of surfaces, it is used in packing industries, automobile industries, preparing any components. First calculate the raw material required. How to calculate the raw material? Take an example. Say this is the component. Say this component covered with a paper. Now what is the development of surfaces? Development of surfaces nothing but what is the raw material required to close this object. Out circumferential surfaces required. Say, just what I am going to show to you, what is the development of this component. Say, for example, this component, just cut out and open. This is the one vertical slide. This is the one more vertical slide. This is the one more vertical slide. This is the one more vertical slide. Say, this is the top one. This is the bottom one. Now, this is the development of surfaces of this component. Say, there are four rectangular slots are available, four rectangular places are available. These are all the four rectangular faces. Four rectangular faces, and this is the top cover, this is the bottom cover. Now, the open cover is development of surfaces. That means, to pack this component in a thin metal sheet, that metal sheet required measurements are, first of all, you calculate. Calculate the raw material required to pack this one. What is the base side? What is the vertical height? What is the rectangular shape? So, now what I mentioned, that this is covering is open out. This covering is open out. Let's first of all close this one. Now, this is closed in a thin sheet of paper, open, this is the one vertical slide, one more vertical slide, now third vertical slide and fourth vertical slide. And this is the top cover open, the bottom cover open. Now, this is nothing but the development of square prism. Development of square prism is this one. Let's observe the diagram, the same object covered with a thin sheet and open, defold it to get. Now, before preparing a component, for example, any component you are going to prepare, first calculate the raw material required and cut that raw material from a bigger sheet and fold according to your requirement, the final component is prepared. That is nothing but sheet metal work. Oil tins are prepared, that is AC ducts are prepared based upon this concept, that is a development of surfaces. Now, this is the development of surfaces. These applications of this one, the very interesting knowledge required to use this concept in industry. All industries preparing the boilers. Boiler, what is the boiler material required? How he is going to fold that raw material into circular shape or any other shape? So, this concept is required. So, once you go to industry, so what essential requirement need this concept? What is meant by development? So, raw material required to prepare this component is nothing but a development. Developments are two methods. That is, parallel line development, radial line development. Any conical objects are there, that type of conical objects are followed by radial line development. Now this we can call it as a parallel development. Now this concept is, so various industries, ship preparation, what is the sheet metal required to ship preparation process, or automobile components, aircrafts, packing industries, that means sheet metal work. This concept is utilized to develop a industrial application objects. Now let's discuss about the methods of development. The methods of development, first discuss about parallel line development. Let first of all take an example of an object. Take an object first of all. Object is, for example, this is the object. Now what is this? I am assuming the object is like this one. Assuming the object. So square prism. First draw the square prism of this one. This is an object. Its front view, top view. Its front view, top view. So this is the front view. That is the front view. Draw the front view. So that is A, B, C, D. That is the front view. Nothing but this one. This one. Top view square. Now, so this is the front view. This is the top view. Now, how many vertical faces are there? Such type of faces. Four faces are there. 1, 2, 3, 4 faces are there. That means scratch out one side and default open. Then we can get the, so parallel, draw a line. Draw a line. Give a gap of this one. Any gap. Now this is any gap. This is the X gap. Then start to open and fold on a white sheet. We can get such a type of vertical faces are 1, 2, 3, 4 faces will come. Then the top one. So this is the one. The bottom one. This is called radial development. Called radial development. Now this type of development we can call it as a parallel line development. Parallel line development is used to develop all type of prisms. Square prism, triangular prism, hexagonal prism, all prisms are cylindrical objects. Cylindrical objects and prisms objects followed by this method, that is called parallel line development method. Now take an example, one more example. Right. Development of a cylinder. Assume a cylindrical object, draw its front view, top view. Assume a cylindrical object, draw its front view, top view. Start with the top view. Now this concept is already covered in projections of solids. Cylinder is a solid. The solid top view. Say this is the first draw the front view top view of that cylinder. XY line. Draw the top view. Top is a circle. Draw the top view circle. This is the center point. Now axis line. Axis height, say for example 65. Diameter is 50. Now project. Now this is the front view, top view of a cylinder. Its height is 65. Then 50 is the diameter. Now our aim is development. Development may be complete development or lateral development. Lateral development only that circumference of a cylindrical object. Circumference, calculate the circumference pi d. Now take any gap, so small gap. Then from starting here, now project the line. What is the circumference? Calculate the circumference. Circumference pi d, 3.14 into 50 mm, 157. 157 will come. Now draw a line length equal to the pi d. Just close it. Right. This is pi d because the measurement when change only just to know the formula. What are the measurement is? Applying this formula, you can get the required length. So this is the rectangular sheet. While open the curvature of this one, open the circumference of this cylindrical object. This is the sheet we achieve. That sheet measurements are vertical height is equal to the same. Vertical height is equal to 65 and the length is equal to calculate the pi d value. Can get this, we can call it as lateral development of a cylinder. This is lateral development. What is a complete development? Complete development means close the top part and the bottom part. Open the top part, top as a circle. Draw a circle at anywhere. Now draw one more circle, touch with this one, touch with this one, draw the circle. That is a top circle. So one more circle is required at the bottom. This is known as complete development of a cylinder, 50 mm diameter, 65 mm height. Now any values may give in the examination. Sometimes you may ask, draw the lateral development of a cylinder, 40 mm diameter, 60 mm height. Lateral development, no required of this circle and the top circle, only required the rectangular sheet, that we can call it as a lateral development. Complete development means, so top circle and the bottom circle be added to this rectangle, that we call complete development. This is about development of cylinder. Let's take one more example of any prism. Before solving the problem, so just I will cover the remaining parts. Let's observe this one. Development of pyramids. Pyramid, one base, one apex. Let's observe the square pyramid. Square pyramid, say A, B, C, D, O. Now this is called side. This is called side. Side. This is called as a slant edge. Now the center, there is a line is there, that we can call it as a axis height. Axis. In problem specification, you may give this side value, say for example, x, this vertical height you will give, this vertical height, say this is y. But we need the slant edge true length. This edge true length is required for the development. Development of this one, triangular shapes of strips will available. Now, first draw solids part. Development of surface is nothing but 50% is the solids, projections of a solid. Draw the projection of a square pyramid. Draw the projections of a square pyramid. Square pyramid, top is a square, front view is a triangle. First draw the front view, top view of this particular pyramid, square pyramid, XY line, XY line. Draw the square. Square. Now find the center. Center nothing but joining corners. A, B, C, D, O. Center. Now this is axis line. Axis line. Axis height you will give with the problem. Now all are on XY line. Say this is A dash, B dash. This is C dash, D dash. Now join. No. This is solid part. Say for example, solid part of this projection is say right. What is this one? So solid part of this one, front view, top view, front view, top view of a pyramid. Draw the development. Development. So now this is the slant edge, or this is the slant edge, we can call it as a S. This is O dash. O is the center point. With the center point, now select O. Draw a slant height. This is the slant height. So slant height. Draw a line equal to slant as it is, or otherwise remove this one. You can keep this construction line like this one, very thin line. You can keep that construction of an arc line, but only we required a straight line. This is about development of pentagonal pyramid, base side, so and so given in the diagram. Now the proceedings of I am going to explaining. Start with the solid part, top view, front view, find the slant height. With the slant height, start develop your drawing. Let's see the one more concept. Now the complete development of a hexagonal pyramid. Now what is the previous problem? Previous problem that observed, this is about only lateral development. What I told, complete development means close the complete box, top cap and bottom cap also. Now here only one base is available, one base. Now this problem can modify. What modification? Draw the complete development. What he asked, draw the development of a pentagonal, draw the lateral development he asked. In place of lateral development, he asked as a complete. Now add one more. What is the object need to add? One pentagonal shape of object need to add. Draw a pentagon here. Say 108. 108. Then. Now this we can call it as a complete development of pentagonal pyramid. Same problem. That is this one. Draw the complete development. Complete development of a hexagonal pyramid. Now only simple steps. First draw the solid part. What is the solid part? Right, XY line. Now draw hexagon, 120 degrees concept. Draw a side, 120 degrees. Then you know how to construct a hexagon. Now no need to discuss. So this concept we already started from geometrical constructions. Then say this is A, B, C, D, E and F. First center, this is the O. Extend the O part. Now up to projector line here onwards. Now let observe. This is some concept what I just drawn. What I drawn, this is the wrong, because exactly, so the center is exactly matching with this C edge. C edge is exactly overlapping the axis line. So because axis line doesn't show, because that is already in the middle, the one more visible edge is overlapping with this one. So no need to right. Now draw visible line. Behind this line, axis line is there, but visible edge is first priority. Now say this is A, B, C, D. Now draw. Now A dash,
B dash, C dash, D dash, E dash, F dash. This is the given data. Say this is what is the height 60, and this is the given side of 25. Now this is the solid part. Then take this as a slant height. This is the origin O dash. Now start the development. Development is complete development. Now O. So development, now O as a center. Take slant edge. Slant edge is, this is the slant edge. Now this has a radius, O as a center up to this S as a radius. Then draw an arc. How much length? We don't know. Draw a random arc. Once you start cutting up the number of sides where it is going to terminate, stop there, and otherwise extend the arc, continue the remaining sides. You required more. Say, what is the side? 25 mm. Now, AB has radius. AB has a radius. Say, this is A, B, C, D, E, and F. And F. This. Then draw lines. Lateral development, remove this one. Remove this one, we can get the lateral development. Similarly, so this is about complete development of a pentagonal pyramid. Base side 30 mm, axis side 50 mm. Now add all these equilateral. Now we can get the final object. So this is the hexagonal. Now the development of a cone, how to develop a cone in a particular given measurements. Now calculate, only angle is the important part, angle is important part. Start with the angle, then complete the rest of the part. So with this one, I am going to close the development of surfaces. That problem sheet I am going to send it to you. With that problem sheet, solve the problems and put in a Google sheet form, then I will correct your sheets. Whatever the errors are there, I am going to write the comments and send to you. Just rectify those errors in the next class. So this is about development of surfaces. Big question will come, very interesting subject, very easy to solve the problems. Thank you. See the next class. One more concept. Good morning to you all. In the previous class, I explained about the conical curves concepts, complete concepts, their applications, how to draw a conical curve. Today, I am going to explain. Conical curves classified based upon eccentricity. You know, if eccentricity is less than 1, ellipse, equal to 1, parabola, greater than 1, hyperbola. Now, start how to draw an ellipse today class. Just simple concepts. Now, quickly, I am going to finish the sequence of steps that are already there in the PPT. Use those sequence of steps, you can draw. But see, the way you proceed, I am going to explain. Now, as per the concept in the previous, first start with directrix line. Now, how to start this one? Draw a directrix line. Draw a directrix line. Draw a directrix line, any vertical line, maybe AB. Select any point C. Draw an axis line. Draw an axis line. Look at a focus point at a distance of 35 mm. So the focus is at a distance of 35 mm. Focus is, that means, say select a focus F point at a distance of C2F 35 mm, just this is the focus point F. Now, as per the concept in the previous class, so the E is equal, what is that, 2/3, that is equal VF by VC. So, that means, now find out the V. V is vertex, find the vertex in between, that means given data is E is equal to 2/3, so that means 2 + 3, so 5. Now divide the CF into 5 equal parts, acute angle method, any line, divide this into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then fifth point to be joined to the F, remaining all lines are parallel to these lines. Where is the V point? So at the 2 equal parts from F, this is vertex point, or 3 equal points from C, 3 equal points. At V, draw vertical line. Draw an arc, V as a center, VF as a radius, draw an arc. So this is, we can call it as a E. Draw a line passing CE. Draw a line. Now, in one and D and extend, one D and draw this line and extend, this is the P1 point. 2C, 2-C, 2-C, 2D, this is the P2, 3C, 3-C, and again 3-C this line, 3C this one. Now 4-C, 4-2D. Now this is the quarter part of our ellipse, quarter part. Apply the mirror image. Mirror image means draw a horizontal line, the left side measurement to be copied on the right side. This is a draw a horizontal line, this point, so left measurement copied to the right. Horizontal line, left measurement to the right. This horizontal line, left. So this is the remaining part of this one. Now draw vertical lines. Through these all the points, draw the vertical lines. Above measurement to below, above, below. Now this is the way. Now, so 1, 2, 3. Now this is an oblong method. This is an oblong method of drawing conical curves. So these four important curves are available. These are all standard problems. So directly will give you the examinations. This is about problem solving of conical curves. This concept already step by step I given in the previous class, but only to draw the sequence, I am giving the sequence how to draw ellipse, parabola, hyperbola. Clear? So this is about, now let's one more concept. Now here it is, you indicate 45 degrees. Then draw the name of the curve, ellipse. Give the value, say this is 35. Then one more extension part will be, will say, draw normal and tangent. Draw normal and tangent to the ellipse, or parabola or hyperbola at a distance. Now draw a normal and a tangent to the curve at a point of 20 mm from the focus. So take a 20 mm as a radius, identify a point on the curve from the focus point. So from focus point to 20, so this is the point, say let be P. How to draw normal and tangent at that particular point? First draw a line from this point to F. Draw a line. Draw a 90 degrees line. This point we can call it as a T. This is 90 degrees. First draw
draw a line through this point to this F and draw a 90 degrees line. Say this is the T, then T and P is the tangent. T is the tangent. T is the tangent. Then now while draw the line, the one more line is like this one. Say this is called normal NM. NM is the normal. Now similarly, how to draw? Draw a normal and tangent at a distance 40 mm from the focus. 40 mm from the focus. From focus to 40 mm. Now this is the point P. What are the steps required? First join the P point to F, then draw 90 degrees line. This is the 90 degrees line. Then this point is called T. Now this is called TT. That point, T point and P point is the T, and a 90 degrees line, NM is the normal. Draw the name of the curve and give the numerical value of this one. And draw the eccentricity, E is equal to VF by VC, that is equal to 1. Then one more. Draw a normal tangent at a distance of 40 mm. At a distance of 40 mm. Now 40 mm point. This is the 40 mm point P. Draw a line. Draw a 90 degrees line. So this is the T. T and P. This is the tangent. This is the normal. Draw hyperbola curve and eccentricity is equal to VF by VC. That is equal to 3 by 2. And the numerical value is 35. So this is about conical curves, practicing the problems. With this, I am going to close conical curves part, and the next class I will start the other part, that is projections of orthographic projections in the next class. Now theory part is completed. The problems, I solved the four problems also solved. You only practice at home and complete this one. Just thank you for prepare this and send these problems for verification. Thank you.